Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Couple of weeks back, I did sit on this particular TV show and I talked about a story that was raving the nation. For a minute, it was viral on social media and the story was Development Channel. Now, I know all of you saw the Facebook posts and the tweets where they talked about, ooh, it's a scam, ooh, people were fighting, ooh, this with that, and I had my opinions. I'm entitled to them. So I had my opinions about that particular story. I did run the story. I called out Salvador, Sheila Gashumba. My whole point, though, wasn't about the story itself. My point was with the artist, and my thoughts on it were simple. As an artist or as a celebrity, you're supposed to know where your brand lies. If you decide to be a brand ambassador for something, you're supposed to 100% believe in it, do your homework, and know that this is what I stand for now. Not because of the money, but you're supposed to let the money motivate you into knowing what you're doing. So that was my take. So today I got invited by the man himself, the man. And all of you have heard about Development Channel. Well, this is the guy behind it. And we're having a sit down to just probably get a few clarifications and So let's delve. Don't forget, this particular episode is proudly sponsored by Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. For all of you who don't have the number, the screen down here, that's the number you can always use to contact us on. But for now, let's delve in another exclusive. Okay, let me let him make his own introduction because I don't think I can get your Nigerian name.
Me? Mm-hmm. What do you know about Nigeria?
I know a lot. I know about cassava.
It's always funny when people say the word Nigeria, uh-huh. Because Nigeria does not represent anything.
It does not?
No, it doesn't.
You don't say.
The geographical location called Nigeria, uh-huh, has never metamorphosed into a nation.
It's just the demographic.
So when you talk about Nigerians, uh-huh, talk about their individual community.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
I'm,
yeah,
Igbo. You can Igbo. Say, oh, how is Igbo? Or mm-hmm, Igbo, something mm-hmm to do with Igbo.
Okay.
I can relate to that better than I'll relate to you saying
you're Nigeria.
Nigeria.
Okay, let's skip that.
Right.
So the name. Let's.
My name is Charles Lambert. Charles Mwabuku Lambert is my middle name.
See, that's why I said I couldn't pronounce
okay
it. How is it?
Say Charles
it
Lambert Mwabuku is my middle name.
Oh.
Wabiku.
Wabiku.
Yes.
Okay, that's good enough.
Try it again.
Wabiku.
It's too easy.
If I was to ask you, give me three lines, just in three lines, tell me why this is not a scam.
All the phones that we use in Africa, mm-hmm, is made by somebody
in China, somewhere.
Yes. Not an African brand, mm-hmm, doesn't give anything back to our community,
true,
doesn't build hospital or clinics, mm-hmm, doesn't support our educational system.
Okay.
Yet they remove $30 billion out of Africa, mm-hmm, every year.
Mm-hmm.
So every single year, $30 billion is lost through phone, people buying phones, Samsung, Tecno. $30 billion go to South Korea to build hospital road. $30 billion from here, from, mm-hmm, Uganda, from Nigeria, from Ghana, goes away to different parts of the world, and it's not developing here, so that's why we're poor.
Okay.
So now we want to manufacture this phone in Mbarara.
Okay.
So we're asking Ugandans, mm, we want to manufacture this phone in Mbarara. Buy this tablet that we're importing,
mm-hmm,
for your child.
Mm-hmm.
From some of our profit in this tablet, we will manufacture the phone. As we're selling the phone across Africa, whatever profit we're making, we'll give you that bought this tablet and supported us. Very simple.
So it was Salvador, what's her name? The skinny thing. She looks like she doesn't eat. Sheila Gashumba, and then there was Matthew Nawiso, and the wife, and Roger Mugisha. Those are the ones that I knew often. And Richard Twanje. And my question though was, how did you zero in on these different people, and what was the criteria? Do you think that they were going to push your agenda much more forward than it was being received? Because if you ask me, I think that was a fail. They all failed at that job.
Yeah, to be honest with you, the idea was to have people who had some sense of a public appeal,
uh-huh,
to understand what it is we're doing.
And you thought of Sheila Gashoma?
I don't even know. See, the truth, I don't know these people. So we had a department in the office who were comprised of Ugandans that grew up here in Uganda.
And those are
and
the people
they selected the people that they felt they...
Can you please fire that entire department?
Are you serious?
They did you bad. Like Michael Jackson bad. Like Joe Jackson bad. That was bad. The accounts that were frozen are not in any light to do with the company being in any kind of wrangle.
Well, the account was frozen. It's exactly the cause of everything that you even got to hear about. Oh. Even the driver's situation you got to hear about.
So that is what caused the bubble
Everything
effect.
Has to do with the fact that our bank accounts have been frozen for 4 months. And I've personally found a way to find resources out of our bank account, our mobile money lines, everything that has to do with our financial way of doing business has been frozen by a government agency called the Capital Markets Authority through another government agency called the Financial Intelligence Authority.
And the reason that they're doing that is?
Yeah, the reason was that we're offering that people are going to get dividend, they're going to get some kind of anything from what we're doing. Now why should we do that? They said if any a kind of offer, that makes a lot of sense, legally speaking.
Legally.
Now in black and white terms, in black and white terms, for a company to do what we're doing, offer to help the public and give them some financial support back.
Someone would think first thing is inflation.
The first thing they will look at it is you're not a publicly traded company. Oh. It is something that is supposed to be reserved for publicly traded companies to do. So the concept of you invested money and then you know you're getting some kind of return, that's the way they interpreted it. And I said you're correct, but there's a middle ground here. The middle ground is that people are getting a product. So the idea of you protecting or saying no, you're not publicly traded doesn't apply
because they're already buying the
product. They're getting a product, but they're getting you're promising them returns for the product. I said, but they're getting a product. That takes you out of. So that's the argument. I said, no, we're government and what we say holds, and then they froze the account.
But
and we have been trying. We've appealed to the Equal Opportunities Commission, saying this thing doesn't make any sense. Like you're freezing the account, trying to protest your position that this thing is practically being a publicly traded company. And we are saying to you, no, it's not, because people are getting a product. And it's affecting people. It's people are losing jobs. People, look at the driver situation. Look at all the other drama that's come out of it.
How long have you been in the country, though?
8 months.
8 months. What's the one thing that you love the most about Uganda?
Appreciation.
How's that?
People are too appreciative here.
Oh, we're thankful.
Yeah, it doesn't last too long. They appreciate. Then after a while, but that initial appreciation is
it's
so nice.
Ugandan music. Do you have a favorite Ugandan artist yet?
I mean, right now, I like Fik. What's his name?
Fik for Maker.
Fik for Maker, yeah.
Fresh Boy. Yeah, if you can't say the full name, just say Fresh Boy.
Yeah, Fresh Boy. I like
Why do you like him, though? He reminds me of
I didn't know anything about him until the first time I spoke to him with about 10 other artists, and he started crying.
My bad.
I was talking about the economic war and the implications of global economies on. He started crying. Crying like a child.
Wow.
I was moved beyond. I said, who is this guy? They said his name is Fik for me. He started explaining he comes from the ghetto and now he understands why his people are poor. He was weeping in tears. So I started now listening to his music. I was like, wow, that's quite impressive. And he's kind of like my boy. I like him.
Do you know what I'm shocked right now? You should see him doing his music videos. And he's like, I'm a mafia. I'm all of this. You cry, Fik. You cry.
But that's a real mafia. A real mafia has heart.
Yeah, like lots of heart.
I cry too. It depends on what gets through to me. You know, Fik.
I don't think I want to see you cry. That's wrong. Like, if you're going to cry, you're going to cry in a room somewhere. But if you cry, that's
deep. Yeah, a lot of people will have a heart attack.
Which other artists have you interfaced with that you think is, they're cool?
Wykie Bender, as a person, but I haven't really seen much of him, I think, after the
As a person?
His music interest and his music vibe.
He's very
ambitious, though. He's a very ambitious kid. And I kind of like that, what he's
about him, like
the ambition and the push to take his music to the next
level. You've not said nothing about Jose Chameleon. Those are like the oldest artists we have in UG.
Well, that's the only people I knew when I came here, but I didn't know who they were again when I came here.
So have you tried to get to know them?
No, I don't know where to find them. My staff are the people that let me know who to find.
Okay, let's just ask you a crazy question. If you were seated in a room and they asked you, so you're going to be seated in a room for about 5 minutes, three people that you would want to be seated in that room with you.
Where?
For like about 2 days. Any Where? Room, lock you in a room, ask for three people that you could spend the 3 days with. Who would they be?
My kids.
Wow. I was deep. Your kids, how many of those you got?
I got five.
Woo, child!
What do you mean? I want like 11 children. I only got five.
So is the wife here too? Did you come with the whole family?
Oh, I'm not married.
Wait, I think I'm lost in translation here.
What do you mean?
Wait, there's five kids.
No, they're not here. Some of my kids are in the UK, some are
okay,
here.
But there's five kids and there's no ring on it?
I'm not married, not yet.
Why?
What do you mean?
Why? Aren't you married? You don't like labels, you've not
found the one. No, I want to get married when I'm ready. I've been too busy.
So you're ready to have kids but not ready
because
to
have a commitment? Because I'm getting older, so the kids should start coming.
Yeah. That's a different.
Yeah, but marriage, you have to be prepared for that. You know, it means that you're going to tell somebody, listen, me and you now, that's it. For the rest of your life.
You're
going to build an institution. Mm-hmm. Marriage, that's what it is, an institution.
And it's something you don't play around
with. So I didn't, I've just started getting ready to think about it now.
Have these Ugandan slay queens tried to put their paws on you? Well, we have lots of those.
Well, I don't know. Women always try, you know. It doesn't matter where you go.
In Uganda, how many?
But now that you're in the picture, I think it's going to be very difficult for anybody to.
I heard you have another project coming up, still on economic warfare for the Ugandan child. This one is for the child, to be specific.
Yes.
Run me through it real quick.
Because there's no African country that pays child support. Child support
welfare.
Will put Uganda as the number one country in Africa. And that's what we're trying to do with the Great Uganda Initiative, is to make Uganda become the reference point. And one of the key ways is to have child support in Uganda.
How are you going to introduce the child support, though? What's the system behind it?
Well, if you have me on your show again, I could explain that.
I know, right? I'll definitely have to have you on one of these beautiful dives. Anyway, it's been good chilling with him. My name is Atina Fierce One. Do not forget, this episode was proudly sponsored by Nana Habo Mouthwash. On Twitter, it's @AtinaFierceOne. And of course, on Facebook, it's @AtinaFierceOne. And Scoop and Scoop. Like, follow the pages. On Instagram, it's @AtinaFierceOne with an H. I'll do this again tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.